Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today we're going to do my Scottish grandmother's recipe for shortbread, or as near as I can get to it. She never actually told me the recipe because boys shouldn't be in the kitchen. So this is just what I remember her doing, and I've pieced it together from other recipes. It really hinges on rice flour. So this is the first time I've ever made it in a stand mixer. If you go back on the channel, back to like 2009, there's a video of Julie making it by hand with a wooden spoon, if you want to watch that one. Let's see what happens. So the first thing we do is just cream up the butter, get it nice and soft and fluffy. Once the butter's whipped up nice and soft, I'm going to add in some sugar. Now this is super fine sugar. Depending on where you live, it could be called fruit sugar. It's just a really, really fine grind, but it's not icing sugar, because icing sugar is a mix, or at least here, icing sugar is a mix of fine grind sugar mixed with cornstarch to give it that powdery texture. This is just finely ground sugar. Next in is the secret ingredient, and that is rice flour. And the rice flour is what gives these cookies such an amazing melt-in-your-mouth texture. Now that this is all creamed together, the last ingredient, this is only four ingredients, is flour, regular all-purpose flour. And when my grandmother did this with a wooden spoon, she wouldn't measure the flour. She would just mix in enough flour until she could no longer mix it with the spoon, and then put it out on the board and knead it in a little bit of flour until it wouldn't pick up any more flour. So we've kind of decided that that's somewhere between a cup and a half and a cup and three quarters. And I'm going to put in probably about three quarters of this, just over a cup and a quarter of what's in this bowl. And then I'm going to put it out onto the table and we'll knead it in the rest. Now I've got about as much flour in with the mixer as I could. So I'll put the rest of the flour out on the bench and then we'll take this ball of dough out. And we'll just knead it into the flour and see if we can get it to pick up any more flour along the way. A little bit sticky, not too bad. It's nice soft dough. And once it stops picking up flour, don't try to knead any more in. It's better to err on the side of not enough than too much. Now today that took pretty much the full cup and three quarters of flour, and I've got a really nice dough here. So what I'm gonna do is cut it in half. Roughly, you don't have to be exact, and I'm going to make each half into a disc that I will wrap up in some plastic wrap and stick in the fridge for about a half an hour before we come back and bake them. Now I'm going to put these out onto a baking sheet and shape them until they're about a quarter inch thick. Once you get it flattened out and try to get it kind of round, just take a fork and dock it roughly where you want to cut it. And you can do it in fourths or sixths or eighths, any size wedge you like. Now this bakes in a relatively low oven. I've got it preheated to 300 degrees Fahrenheit. It takes somewhere between 45 minutes and an hour. Keep an eye on it. And then after you wait about 10 minutes for it to cool, you can cut them. And they cut really nicely into these little triangles.
Yay! Hi, friends. Hey, Glen.
Shortbreads.
I love shortbread.
Oh, I love shortbread, too.
I'm okay. Totally going to take one from here, though, just because I don't want to ruin your lovely display there,
Glen. My shortbread display?
Uh-huh. Mm. That is melt-in-your-mouth tasty.
Completely melt-in-your-mouth. Yeah. Now, I made these with the stand mixer. I don't think I'd make it with the stand mixer again. I think this is a wooden spoon operation.
My granny would say so.
Yeah. And the texture on these is great. It is melt in the mouth, but the texture on a wooden spoon one just is even meltier.
It really makes a difference.
I don't know. In my mind, in the romantic part of my brain, it makes a difference. But these are fantastic.
Now, I can tell from the recipe you've done the rice flour version. Yeah. That being said, I like the straight up flour butter version as well.
Do you? I prefer the rice flour.
I do. I prefer the rice flour, yeah. But I will eat both of them. And I have to say that every time, I tend to only make these once a year.
Mm-hmm.
And then I always say to myself, why is it these aren't in my regular rotation of cookies?
Four ingredients, super easy to make. Why are they not in the regular rotation of cookies we make?
This is the question. We always go with the peanut butter, chocolate chip. These are our standards, brownies. You know.
So 2021 is going to be a much better year than 2020 because we are going to have shortbread in our regular cookie rotation.
Way to improve 2021.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.